turn my steps to the altar of God, the gladness of my life. I will turn my steps to the altar of God, the gladness of my life. Show your justice in pleading my cause. Let me walk in the way of your love. I will turn my steps to the altar of God, the gladness of my life. I will turn my steps to the altar of God, the gladness of my life. Lead me on with your power and strength, and my courage will never be spent. I will turn my steps to the altar of God, the gladness of my life. I will turn my steps to the altar of God, the gladness of my life.
See, I have God for my help. The Lord sustains my soul. I will sacrifice to you with willing heart and praise your name, O Lord, for it is good. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, today's readings teach us that God is patient and compassionate with us, and He is always hopeful that the weeds in us can be converted to good wheat. Therefore, He allows us to grow as we are. Let us inculcate in ourselves the goodness God shows us for others. We know none of us is perfect. We all need to grow. We all need to be corrected. We all need to be converted. And God allows us. He gives us the time. He does not pluck us at once when He sees that we are not perfect, when He sees there is a weakness in us, but He allows us to grow to the full. So as we celebrate this Holy Eucharist, let us ask and pray for a special grace from God, that we may be also compassionate to our companions, to our neighbors, to our friends and our family members, as God is compassionate to me and to you. And thus, we will not make many mistakes. We may not judge people because we know we are also weak. So let us ask for that grace from God to be compassionate and not be judging others, as God does not judge me at once. Now, recalling to mind all our failures and sins, let us be sorry for all our sins so that we may worthily participate in this Holy Eucharist. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy on us all. Lord, have mercy on us.
Let us pray. Show favor, O Lord, to your servants, and mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that made fervent in hope, faith, and charity, they may be ever watchful in keeping your commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
First reading, a reading from the Book of Wisdom, chapter 12, verses 13 and 16 to 19. There is no other God besides thee, whose care is for all men, to whom thou shouldst prove that thou hast not judged unjustly. For thy strength is the source of righteousness, and thy sovereignty over all causes thee to spare all. For thou dost show thy strength when men doubt the completeness of thy power, and dost rebuke any insolation among those who know it. Thou who art sovereign in strength, dost judge with mildness, and with great forbearance thou dost govern us. For thou hast power to act whenever thou dost choose. Through such works thou hast taught thy people that the righteous man must be kind. And thou hast filled thy sons with the good hope because thou gavest repentance for sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
O God, my God, for you my soul is thirsty. O God, my God, for you my soul is thirsty. O God, you are my God, for you I long, for you my soul is thirsty. O God, my God, for you my soul is thirsty. Like a dry weary land without water, my body pines for you, O Lord. O God, my God, for you my soul is thirsty.
Second reading, a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans, chapter 8, verses 26 and 27. The Spirit helps us in our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought. But the Spirit Himself intercedes for us with sighs too deep for words. And He who searches the hearts of men knows what is in the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for the saints according to the will of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Praise be the Lord. Praise be the Lord. Alleluia. Praise be the Lord. Alleluia. Praise be the Lord. Alleluia. Praise be the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus put a parable before the crowd, saying, "The kingdom of heaven may be compared to a man who sowed good seed in his field. But while men were sleeping, his enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and went away. So when the plants came up and bore grain, then the weeds appeared also, and the servants of the householder came and said to him, 'Sir, did you not sow good seed in your field? How then has it weeds?' He said to them, 'An enemy has done this.' The servants said to him, 'Then do you want us to go and gather them?' But he said, 'No, lest in gathering the weeds you root up the wheat along with them. Let both grow together until the harvest. And at harvest time I will tell the reapers, gather the weeds first and bind them in bundles to be burned, but gather the wheat into my barn.' Another parable he put before them, saying, 'The kingdom of heaven is like a grain of mustard seed, which a man took and sowed in his field. It is the smallest of all seeds, but when it has grown, it is the greatest of the shrubs and becomes a tree, so that the birds of the air come and make nest in its branches.' He told them another parable. 'The kingdom of heaven is like leaven, which a woman took and hid in 3 measures of meal till it was all leavened. All this Jesus said to the crowds in parables. Indeed, he said nothing to them without a parable. This was to fulfill what was spoken by the prophet. I will open my mouth in parables. I will utter what has been hidden since the foundations of the world. Then he left the crowds and went into the house, and his disciples came to him saying, "Explain to us the parable of the weeds of the field." He answered, "He who sows the good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world, and the good seed means the sons of the kingdom, and the weeds are the sons of the evil one, and the enemy who sowed them is the devil. The harvest is the close of the age, and the reapers are angels. Just as the weeds are gathered and burnt with fire, so will it be at the close of the age. The Son of Man will send his angels, and they will gather out of his kingdom all causes of sin and all evildoers, and throw them into the furnace of fire. There men will weep and gnash their teeth. Then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. He who has ears, let him hear." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear friends in Jesus Christ, today we have three parables told to us by Jesus himself. The parable of the mustard seed, the parable of the leaven, and the parable of the seeds. In the first parable, or the smallest parable, we have the example of the kingdom of God beginning from a small point, as the mustard seed is the smallest seeds of all, but it grows into a tree where the birds of the air come and take shadow. So is the kingdom of heaven. It begins in our heart from a small point, then it grows to a big tree. Or the same message is conveyed by the third parable, the parable of the leaven. But today's biggest parable, the parable of the wheat and the weeds, conveys us a lots of messages. First thing, we are the field for the word of God. God plants his seeds in our hearts. And weeds, there are weeds, troublesome weeds. Why the householder did not tell his servants to pluck the weeds? Because he knew the wheat also could be destroyed. Because there is a weed called darnel, which appears like the wheat, and it entwinkles through the roots. So if you're going to pluck the weeds, naturally the wheat has to be plucked along. So thus the householder, knowing well of the results, he tells his servants, "Wait till both are grown up. Wait till the time of the harvest, because then it can be separated with the hand." And that is how God knows. And what is the message for us? The weeds indicate in the parable those hard-hearted sinners, those who are not ready to change their heart, those who are not ready to change themselves, those who are not ready for the conversion, not ready to listen to the word of God, and they will be burned at the time of the harvest or at the end of the age. We are not to be discouraged when we see lot of weeds within the church, within our families, within ourselves, and around our surroundings. Because none of us is perfect. We are called to grow to perfection. And the weaknesses we have within us has to be overcome, is to be converted into the virtues. Like If we say, taking the example of the apostles themselves, Peter had a weakness. He denied Jesus. Judas betrayed Jesus. Thomas doubted Jesus. James and John desired for a higher positions, had ambitions, but Jesus did not pluck them from group of the apostles. He continued, took them along. And at the end, what happens? Only Judas is remained as a weed. He could not, or he did not ask pardon for his sinfulness. So, but others, Peter, Thomas, James, and John, they grew up, they were converted, they changed themselves, they believed in Jesus, and they were ready, and they sacrificed their lives for God. That is how, in the second reading, we learn, the Spirit of God helps us to grow in perfections. It helps us to follow the ways of God. It helps us to listen to the word of God. It helps us to pray to God. So it is God is always assisting us, helping us. We should never be discouraged when we see a lot of mishappenings around us. We should always trust in the Lord. We know there are so many people who are doing evil, who not doing justice to others, doing injustice to others, still grow better in life, in achieving lot of riches, but that is for a little while. But people who are those who are suffering for the word of God, their happiness is longer, everlasting. Today's parable gives another message to us that we should pray for others' conversions. When we see the weaknesses in others, we should not be discouraged. We should not be at once ready to judge them. God did not judge. When the servants came to the householder to pluck the weeds, he said, let them grow. Let them grow till the end. So this day also teaches, let us not judge others. Let us be slow to judging others. Let us be compassionate to others. Let us pray for others. Let us help others to grow in goodness. Let us be example to others to be followers of God. Secondly, we cannot judge others because we ourselves carry within us a mixture of goodness and badness. Therefore, we are supposed to understand others. We are supposed to help others. Because we are sometimes not better than the other people. So, dear friends, let us understand the readings of today. God is compassionate to us. God is compassionate to me. God is merciful to me. Am I also merciful to my companions? Am I ready to forgive as God is always ready to forgive me? Am I ready to understand others as God is understanding me? God is not seen in today's reading as a strict judge, but as a compassionate father. Let me learn from my compassionate father to be compassionate to others. In the second reading, we hear the Holy Spirit guiding me. Am I open to the Holy Spirit? Spirit of the Lord, which guides me, which perfects me in my weaknesses. Let us be open to the Spirit of the Lord, because we will be guided according to the will of the Father, so that we may bear much fruit, some 30, some 60, and some 100-fold. Amen. I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Let us pray to the Heavenly Father, who is compassionate and merciful to us always. Let us present all our needs before Him and say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Church, that in her ministry of the word and service, she may continue to promote the good and weed out the evil, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the world, so blessed with good and yet burdened with evil, that its leaders may strive to foster all that helps human community, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For us, that we may accept that there is good in the worst of us and evil in the best of us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our youth, the present, both of the world and the Church, that they may be guided and encouraged as they launch out uncharted routes, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our dear departed ones, that they may be granted the bliss of beholding God face to face in heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Now let us present all our needs and petitions which are in our hearts. Let us pray in silence. We know Mother Mary is always ready to help us. So let us present all our petitions through the help of Mary to the Father, saying, Hail Mary,
full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Heavenly Father, receive all our prayers and bless all of us. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
On this day of joy, on this day of hope, we come to you in love, O Lord. On this day of joy, on this day of hope, we come to you in love. With this bread and wine we come to this Eucharistic feast. On this day of joy, on this day of hope, we come to you in on this day of joy, on this day of hope, we come to you in love, O Lord. On this day of joy, on this day of hope, we come to you in love. Bread to be your body, Lord, wine to be your saving blood. On this day of joy, on this day of hope, we come to you in love.
Pray, brethren, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church.
O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion varied offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants and make it holy as you bless the gifts of Abel, so that what each has offered to the honor of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so, with all the angels, we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, earth is full of your glory. Glory fills the heavens too. Sing to him, Hosanna. Blessed is
you are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took the bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." the mystery of faith.
He is Lord, He is Lord. He has risen from the dead and He is Lord. Every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, our spouse, especially with the most, and with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and our bishops, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Heavenly Father in the words Jesus gave us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, O Jesus Christ, take away our sins, and have mercy on us all, and have mercy on us. Lamb of God, O Jesus Christ, take away our sins, and have mercy on us all, and have mercy on us. Lamb of God, O Jesus Christ, take away our sins. Grant us peace, O grant us peace. Grant us peace forever.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
When the kindness of our God was revealed in Jesus, with compassion and with love were we born. In the spirit of that love, life abounds with thankfulness for the gifts we know in Jesus the Christ. May the grace of God be ever in our lives. With this song may gratitude become our home. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia. With the gentleness peace born in love of God as friend, so much healing and forgiveness shall we know. And with peace is sure to come such a deep abiding joy, which the many deaths of life cannot dispel. May the grace of God be ever in our lives. With this song may gratitude become a home. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord, the gracious, the merciful, has made a memorial of his wonders. He gives food to those who fear him. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Remember,
O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled your protection, implored your help, and sought your intercession, was left unaided. Inspired with this confidence, I fly unto you, O Virgin of Virgins, my Mother,
to you I come, before you I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word Incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in your mercy, hear and answer me. Amen.
Mary, Queen of Peace,
pray for us.
Want it to grow and increase.